Hello students, let's start today with the types of equilibria, and there are two types of equilibria. One is homogeneous equilibria and the second one is heterogeneous equilibria. Homogeneous equilibria, when in an equilibrium condition, all the reactants and the products are present in the same phase. They may be gaseous or liquid. It is called as a homogeneous equilibrium. Let's consider the examples of the reactions in the gaseous phase. There are two types. One is in which the number of moles of product is equal to the number of moles of reactants. So in this case, hydrogen is reacting with iodine and it results in the formation of hydrogen iodide. All reactants and products are present in gaseous phase there. Similarly, nitrogen reacts with oxygen to form nitric oxide. N2 plus O2 gives 2NO. All reactants and products are present in gaseous phase. So it comes under homogeneous equilibria. Let's see type 2. In type 2, the reactions in which the number of moles of products is not equal to the number of moles of reactants. So in this case, nitrogen reacts with hydrogen to form ammonia. Sulfur dioxide reacts with oxygen to form sulfur trioxide. Here, although the number of moles of reactants and products are not equal, but still all are present in gaseous phase, and that's why it comes under the example of homogeneous equilibria. Then two common examples of the reactions in the liquid phase are acetic acid, CH3COOH, reacts with ethyl alcohol, ethanol, C2H5OH, and it results in the formation of ester, CH3COO, C2H5, along with the formation of water, H2O. All are present here, reactants as well as products are present in liquid phases there. And that's why it comes under the example of homogeneous equilibria. Second case is heterogeneous equilibria, wherein in an equilibrium reaction, the reactants and products are present in two or more than two phases. It is called a heterogeneous equilibrium. Let's consider a few examples. Here you can see calcium carbonate is present in solid phase and it gets decomposed to calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. Calcium oxide is present here in solid state and carbon dioxide is present there in gaseous phase. So here the reactants and products are not present in the same phase there. That's why it comes under heterogeneous equilibria. Another example, we can see iron combines with water and it forms Fe3O4 plus hydrogen is the gas that is evolved. Iron is present there in solid state. Water is present there in gaseous state and Fe3O4 formed is solid and hydrogen is present in gaseous state. So reactants and products are not present in the same phases there, and that's why it comes under the example of heterogeneous equilibria. Now, molar concentration of pure solids and pure liquids are taken to be constant. The value is taken as unity. And the reason why molar concentration of pure liquid or solid is taken as unity or it's considered as constant, because molar concentration is defined as number of moles of the substance per volume of the substance there. If I convert moles into mass by putting in the formula molar concentration equals to mass of the substance upon molecular mass whole divided by volume of the substance. So mass by volume, we know very well know that it is equal to density into 1 by molecular mass. We know that density of a pure substance at a particular temperature is constant. It depends only on the nature of the substance and not on the amount. And molecular mass of the substance is also constant. Therefore, molar concentration is constant there. So its value, the molar concentration of pure solids and pure liquids is taken as one, unity. It's taken as constant. Hope you have understood. Let's look at some of the examples for homogeneous equilibrium. For the reaction, H2 plus I2 gives 2HI. All are present in gaseous phases. Kc will be equal to HI to the power square, molar concentration, of course, divided by molar concentration of hydrogen into molar concentration of iodine. Or Kp, since it is gaseous, all are present in the gaseous state, we can calculate Kp for the reaction. Kp for the reaction is partial pressure of HI to the power 2 whole divided by partial pressure of hydrogen into partial pressure of iodine. Similarly, you can see for N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. This is formation of ammonia. Kc is equal to NH3 molar concentration to the power 2 divided by molar concentration of nitrogen into molar concentration of hydrogen to the power 3. Or if, since all are present in gaseous phase, we can also calculate the Kp for the reaction. So Kp for this reaction equals to partial pressure of NH3 to the power 2 divided by partial pressure of nitrogen into partial pressure of hydrogen to the power 3. And for heterogeneous equilibrium, let's consider the reaction calcium carbonate decomposition. Calcium carbonate is present here in solid state. On heating, it gives calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide there. So it comes under heterogeneous equilibria, and by applying law of chemical equilibrium, we can calculate the value of K equals to calcium oxide molar concentration into carbon dioxide molar concentration upon calcium carbonate molar concentration. Just now I said for pure solids and pure liquids, the value of calcium oxide and calcium carbonate, by convention, we take its value as 1 or unity. So K here is equal to only molar concentration of carbon dioxide. Since the concentration of a gas is usually expressed in terms of partial pressures, hence we can write Kp for this reaction equals to partial pressure of carbon dioxide. And this explains why pressure of carbon dioxide becomes constant when equilibrium is attained in the decomposition of calcium carbonate in a closed vessel. Let's find out the units of equilibrium constant. If you consider a general equation, AA plus BB gives XX plus YY. Kc is equal to X to the power X molar concentration into Y to the power Y whole divided by A to the power A into B to the power B, whose value, when you calculate, when you put the units of it, it comes out to be moles per liter raised to delta N, where delta N is X plus Y minus A plus B. That is number of moles of gaseous products minus number of moles of gaseous reactants. Similarly, we can calculate Kp also in terms of partial pressures, and the unit comes out to be atmosphere raised to delta N or bar raised to delta N. If delta N equals to 0, that is number of moles of product is equal to number of moles of reactants, in that case, Kc or Kp will have no units there. Example, you can see hydrogen on treatment with iodine gives hydrogen iodide, or N2 plus O2 gives 2NO. Kc or Kp will have no units, as Np is equal to Nr here, that is the value of delta N equals to 0. But for the reaction, N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. The value of delta N here is 2 minus 1 plus 3, which is equal to minus 2. So Kc has the units moles per liter raised to minus 2, or Kp has units atmosphere raised to minus 2 or bar raised to minus 2 there. Similarly, for the reaction, PCl5 gives PCl3 plus Cl2. Value of delta N here is equal to 1. So Kc has the units moles per liter and Kp has got the unit atmosphere or bar. Now, applications of equilibrium constant. Pay attention to this part. It is, we will see this under three heads. First is predicting the extent of the reaction. So looking at the values of the magnitude of the equilibrium constant, we can predict the direction of the reaction, that is whether it will proceed in the forward direction, whether it will proceed in the backward direction, or whether it will remain in equilibrium with one another. Keep in mind, larger the value of equilibrium constant, that is when the magnitude of equilibrium constant is greater than 10 raised to 3, in that case the reaction is favored in the forward direction there. That is, concentrations of products is much larger than that of the reactants at equilibrium. So you can see this example, hydrogen reacting with bromine, 300 Kelvin, and it results in giving you 2 HBr. Kc for this is 5.4 into 10 raised to 18. So the equilibrium constant Kc value is greater than 10 raised to 3. It favors forward reaction. Similarly, H2 plus Cl2 gives 2 HCl. Kc is 4 into 10 raised to 31. H2 plus half O2 is H2O. Kc is 2.4 into 10 raised to 47. So since the equilibrium concentration values are very high, the reactions almost go to completion there. That means the reaction proceeds in the forward direction. But if the value of equilibrium constant is intermediate between 10 raised to minus 3 to 10 raised to 3, then the concentrations of the reactants and products are comparable. I mean to say they are in equilibrium with one another. You can take the example of H2 plus I2 gives 2 HI. At 700 Kelvin, Kc is here equal to 57. So since the value of Kc, the magnitude is in between 10 raised to minus 3 to 10 raised to plus 3, it is that both the reactants and the products are in equilibrium with one another. Similarly, another example, iron ion reacts with SCN thiocyanate ion and it forms FeSCN2+. Kc here is 138 at 298 Kelvin. So the reactants and the products are in equilibrium with one another and are comparable. But the third case is if the value of Kc is less than 10 raised to minus 3. That means the magnitude of equilibrium constant is less than 10 raised to minus 3. In that case, you can see that the reaction is favored in the backward direction there. Take the example, nitrogen combines with oxygen to form nitric oxide at 298 Kelvin. Kc here is 4.8 into 10 raised to minus 31. So the value of equilibrium constant is much less than 10 raised to minus 3. So the reaction is favored in the backward direction there. Another example, you can take H2O, gaseous state at 500 Kelvin, gets decomposed to H2 plus half O2, and its Kc value is 4.1 into 10 raised to minus 48. So the reaction favors the backward direction there. Or the concentration of reactants is much larger than that of the products. That is, the reaction proceeds to a very small extent in the forward direction there. I hope this part is clear. Looking at the magnitude, look at the diagram. The dependence of extent of reaction on Kc. So when the value of Kc is greater than 10 raised to 3, reaction proceeds almost to completion, large value of Kc. Small value of Kc, that is the value of Kc is less than 10 raised to minus 3, the reaction hardly proceeds. And if it proceeds, it proceeds in the backward direction there. And when the values are in between 10 raised to minus 3 to 10 raised to 3, both reactants and products are in equilibrium with one another. The second case is predicting the direction of reaction. Let's consider a reaction AA plus BB gives XX plus YY. At any stage of the reaction, other than the stage of the chemical equilibrium, concentration ratio as given by the expression for the law of chemical equilibrium is called as concentration quotient, or it is called as reaction quotient, and it's represented by QC. So here concentration quotient or reaction quotient QC equals to x to the power x molar concentration into y to the power y divided by a to the power a into b to the power b. Keep in mind, when the value of QC is less than KC, in that case the reaction proceeds in the forward direction. Once again I repeat, when the value of QC is less than KC, the reaction proceeds in the forward direction. But if the value of QC is greater than KC, in that case the reaction proceeds in the backward direction. The backward direction, QC greater than KC, the reaction proceeds in the backward direction there. And when the value of QC equals to KC, the reaction is in equilibrium with one another. So let's see with the help of diagram. Keep this diagram in your mind. When the value of QC is less than KC, the reaction proceeds in the forward direction, that is the reactants react to form the products there. When QC equals to KC, both reactants and products are in equilibrium with one another. And when the value of QC is greater than that of KC, the reaction proceeds in the backward direction there. So products result in the formation of reactants. So this is the second way in which we can predict the direction of the reaction, calculating the value of QC. The third case is calculating equilibrium concentrations there. Knowing the initial concentration of the reactants, equilibrium concentrations of all the reactants and products can be calculated through the following steps. The first step is write the balanced equation for the reaction. Second step, assume X as the amount of the reactant reacted or a product formed. Third step is calculate the equilibrium concentration of each reactant and product from the stoichiometry of the equation. Fourth step, write expression for KC or KP. Fifth step is substitute equilibrium concentrations and calculate the value of X. Then last step, check the result by substituting calculated values of equilibrium concentrations to get the values of KC or KP. I'll deal with an example here. Suppose 2 moles of A react with 1 mole of B and it results in the formation of C moles. C, 1 mole of C plus 2 moles of D. Initially, suppose A is A moles per liter and B, let it be B moles per liter there. Then at equilibrium, X moles of it are reacted from A. Then A minus X moles of A remain at equilibrium. B minus X by 2 moles of B remain at equilibrium. X by 2 moles of C are formed and X moles of D is formed. So I can calculate the value of KC from this. KC is equal to C molar concentration into D molar concentration to the power 2 divided by molar concentration of A to the power 2 into molar concentration of B. So we'll put the values and we can calculate the value of X, and we'll discuss this problem. See this problem 7.4. The value of KC equals to 4.24 at 800 Kelvin for the reaction. And the reaction is carbon monoxide in its gaseous phase reacts with water in its gaseous phase, and it results in giving you carbon dioxide gas plus hydrogen gas. Calculate equilibrium concentrations of carbon dioxide, hydrogen, carbon monoxide and water at 800 Kelvin. If only carbon monoxide and water are present initially at concentrations of 0.10 molar each. So this is the question given. Let's see the solution to it. So it's given reaction, carbon monoxide reacts with water to form carbon dioxide plus hydrogen there. Initial concentration of carbon monoxide and water are given in the question. It's 0.1 molar. of carbon monoxide and 0.1 molar of water. Initially, carbon dioxide and hydrogen are not formed. But at equilibrium, x moles per liter of each of the product, suppose it is formed. Then at equilibrium, carbon monoxide remaining is 0.1 minus x molar. Water remaining is 0.1 minus x molar. Carbon dioxide formed is x molar and hydrogen also formed is x molar. So when you write equilibrium constant reaction Kc is equal to carbon dioxide molar concentration into hydrogen molar concentration upon carbon monoxide molar concentration into water molar concentration there. So when I put, I get the value of Kc here as x square upon 0.1 minus x square. Kc is given here as 4.24 and it results in giving you a quadratic equation of the type ax square plus bx plus c equals to zero. And the solution for this equation is x equals to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. You have read this quadratic equations in mathematics in class 10. And this is the solution for calculation of x for a quadratic equation. X equals to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So on putting the values, we can get the value of x. We get two values of x there. One is 0.067 and the other one is 0.194. We cannot take the higher value, that is 0.194, because the concentration here is given as only 0.1 molar. So we cannot take a higher value. So we proceed with the x lower value of x, that is 0.067. And we can calculate the equilibrium concentrations for both carbon dioxide and hydrogen is equal to x. So x value we got here as 0.067 molar. Similarly, carbon monoxide and water is equal to 0.1 minus x. We assumed 0.1 minus 0.067 gives the value 0.033 molar. So this is how you'll solve such problems related to quadratic equations. Next problem, this also forms the quadratic equation. The question is, the value of Kp for the reaction carbon dioxide plus carbon gives carbon monoxide 2 moles is 3 at 1000 Kelvin. If initially partial pressure of carbon dioxide is equal to 0.48 bar and partial pressure of carbon monoxide equals to 0 bar and pure graphite is present, calculate the equilibrium partial pressures of carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide there. Now for this reaction, let x be the decrease in the pressure of carbon dioxide. First, let us consider the initial pressure of carbon dioxide here as 0.48 bar. And if x be the decrease in the pressure of carbon dioxide, then at equilibrium, 0.48 minus x bars are present, carbon dioxide, and carbon monoxide formed is 2x bar. We can calculate by putting in the formula Kp equals to partial pressure of carbon monoxide to the power 2 upon partial pressure of carbon dioxide. So Kp equals to 2x square divided by 0.48 minus x. Kp value is given here as 3. So again, it results in the formation of a quadratic equation. 4x square plus 3x minus 1.44 equals to 0. And the solution for this equation is x equals to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac, the whole divided by 2a. So we can calculate the value of x. We get two values of x. The negative value is neglected and we take the positive value of x, which comes out to be 0.33. And thus the equilibrium partial pressures for carbon monoxide, 2x we consider is equal to 2 into 0.33 bar is equal to 0.66 bar. Similarly, partial pressure for carbon dioxide is 0.48 minus x. So 0.48 minus 0.33 gives 0.15 bar. Thus, you'll calculate the problems related to that of quadratic equations. Now look at this simple problem. The question is, the value of Kc for the reaction 2A, reversible reaction it is, B plus C is 2 into 10 raised to minus 3. At a given time, the composition of reaction mixture is molar concentration of A equals to molar concentration of B equals to molar concentration of C equals to 3 into 10 raised to minus 4 molar. In which direction the reaction will proceed? So here you will consider, calculate the value of QC first. And then you will compare the value of QC with that of KC. If QC is less than KC, then the reaction will proceed in the forward direction. But if QC is greater than KC, the reaction proceeds in the backward direction. So here you see, when we calculate the value of QC, we get the value of QC here as 3 into 10 raised to minus 4 molar. QC value is, A equals to B equals to C is given as 3 into 10 raised to minus 4 molar. When you calculate the value of QC, the value of QC comes out to be here as 1. So here, since the value of QC is greater than KC there, the reaction proceeds in the backward direction there. QC greater than KC, reaction proceeds in the backward direction. So you need to predict whether the reaction proceeds in the forward direction or backward. So since here in this case, QC greater than KC, reaction proceeds in the reverse direction. Look at this problem. Question is, 3 moles of PCl5 kept in a 1 liter closed reaction vessel was allowed to attain equilibrium at 300 Kelvin. Calculate the composition of the mixture at equilibrium. Kc is equal to 1.80. Now, PCl5, reversible sign gives PCl3 plus Cl2. Initial concentration of PCl5 is given here as 3 moles. At equilibrium, suppose x moles of it gets dissociated. So remaining PCl5 is 3 minus x. PCl3 formed is x. And Cl2 formed is also x moles. So we can calculate Kc from this reaction by putting in the formula Kc equals to molar concentration of PCl3 into molar concentration of Cl2 whole divided by molar concentration of PCl5. Again, it assumes a quadratic equation of the type x square plus 1.80x minus 5.40 equals to 0. We will calculate the value of x by putting in the formula x equals to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. And we neglect the negative value and we can calculate the value of molar concentration of PCl5 at equilibrium. That is 3 minus x, 3 minus 1.59 gives you the value of 1.41 molar. Similarly, molar concentration of PCl3 and Cl2, they are equal to x, which is 1.59 molar respectively. So this is how you will calculate the values. Next problem you see, it is 13.8 gram of N2O4 was placed in 1 liter reaction vessel at 400 Kelvin and allowed to attain equilibrium. N2O4 gives 2 moles of NO2. The total pressure at equilibrium was found to be 9.15 bar. Calculate Kc, Kp and partial pressures at equilibrium there. So here we'll use the formula of ideal gas equation. Pv equals to nRT and we calculate the pressure first. So P into 1 liter volume is given 1 is equal to number of moles we'll calculate by putting in the formula given mass upon molar mass. Molar mass of N2O4 is 92 grams per mole. So 13.8 by 92 comes out to be 0.15 moles. So 0.15 into R value will take here 0.083 bar liter per mole per Kelvin into temperature here is given as 400 Kelvin. So partial pressure here comes out to be 4.98 bar. Now we'll consider the equation N2O4 in its gaseous state gives 2NO2 in its gaseous phase. Initial pressure we calculated just now. For N2O4 is 4.98 bar, NO2 is not formed, but at equilibrium, suppose P moles react, remaining N2O4 will be 4.98 minus P. And suppose formation of NO2 will be 2P there. Therefore, 4.98 minus P plus 2P is equal to 9.15 bar. That is the total pressure at equilibrium. Thus, you can calculate the value of P here and it comes out to be 4.17 bar. Therefore, partial pressure of N2O4 is equal to 4.98 minus P is equal to 4.98 minus 4.17 equals 0.81 bar. Similarly, partial pressure of NO2 is equal to 2P. So 2 into 4.17, which gives you the value of 8.34 bar. So we calculated the partial pressures here. Now I can calculate the value of KP. Since this is gas, all are present in gaseous phase, we can calculate KP for the reaction. KP is equal to partial pressure of NO2 to the power 2 divided by partial pressure of N2O4. The partial pressure of NO2, we got it here as 8.34 square divided by partial pressure of N2O4 is 0.81 bar. So 0.81, which gives you the value of KP here as 85.87. We can calculate the value of KC by putting in the relation KP equals to KCRT delta N. Here the value of delta N, you can calculate 2 moles of gaseous products minus 1 mole of gaseous reactant. So 2 minus 1 is 1. So KP equals to KCRT delta N. KP is 85.87. KC you need to calculate, R 0.083 into temperature is given here as 400. And delta N value is 1. So we can calculate the value of KC and it comes out to be 2.586. Approximately it is 2.6. So you can practice more numericals related to this equilibrium questions, equilibrium constant questions, and thus you can have a good practice on it and your concept will be clear. So thank you children. In the next class, we'll be dealing about the factors affecting the equilibria and also Lee-Chatelier's principle in detail. Till then, have a nice day.